Hey guys, today we're going to talk about slope. And most of you guys know the definition of slope, or at least a kind of a loose definition, that slope is equal to rise over run. And we'll talk more in detail of what that exactly means. But we are going to, today's lesson is going to determine the slope of a line given any two points that happen to be on the line. Okay, and we're going to look at some other algebraic equations that define slope. So another one is slope equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. Now, often this can be intimidating to some people unless they look at it as this. Okay, basically, these are just the coordinates of some point 2. So if I had a point 2, we're just saying that those would be the coordinates x2, y2, y sub 2. And this would just be the coordinates of a point 1. And what many students at first get a little anxiety over this is if this is some sort of mathematical thing, but this is not an exponent. It's not a power, we're not multiplying, subtracting, anything. It's just identifying the two different coordinates. Like this x and this x are just different coordinates on their respective points. So don't freak out too much about this. The next definition really encompasses all of these. And it's just saying that the slope is the change of y, and this delta y, that's the Greek letter for change, delta, and delta x. So it's the way that y changes as we change x. And all three of these, while they may look different, they all basically describe the same thing. Our rise is the way things change in the y direction, up or down. And that's what this is saying. This is saying the difference of two y coordinates. And that's what this is saying, the change of y. Okay, and that, again, goes back to the rise. Our run is saying that's the way that things change in the x direction. Okay, and this is just the difference between two x coordinates. So they may look different, but these three are exactly the same. So before we jump into the actual calculations, let's just get an idea of slope. And I'm going to use the change of y over the change of x. And first, throw out a line. There's a line in space. Notice there's no points or coordinate graphs. And if I were to ask you something about this line, I would hope that you understood that this has a positive slope. And sometimes just whether the slope is positive or negative is the most important thing. All linear functions must have a slope. And I should say must have a numerical slope. If it's a linear function, it must have a numerical slope. So if I look at any two points on a line, and I read from left to right, and basically reading from left to right means I'm reading as x is increasing. So as x increases and I hit a point here, as I keep increasing x, what happens to y? Well, y is also increasing. And so we define this as a positive slope. As x increases, y increases. And this would be an increasing function. As the input x increases, the output y increases. Okay, now if I'm reading from left to right, and I notice this function, notice as x is increasing, as soon as I hit one point and then compare it to the next point, as x is increasing, now we see that y is decreasing in the x direction and the y direction. So we call this a negative slope. We define it as a negative slope, and it's a decreasing function. That means when our input, our x's are increasing, our outputs are now decreasing. Then we have this situation. Now think what happens as x increases. Think of some point A and B. Think of the value as x increases. What happens to y? Well, it's definitely not going up as a positive slope. It's definitely not going down as a negative slope. What's in between the positive and negative? 0. And again, this is the integer 0. And this is a horizontal line, and the slope of all horizontal lines is 0. We call this a constant function. In other words, when the input x is increasing, the output y stays the same, or we say is constant. And then finally, we have this situation. Notice, well, this is kind of a bad diagram because x is not increasing. Okay, notice that these two points, and I'll just label them A and B, notice the x's don't change at all. And as we run into this, hopefully you realize that this is a vertical line. And since it's a vertical line, it's not a function. And since it's not a function, it doesn't have to have a slope. And in fact, it does not have a slope. And sometimes when we calculate it, we refer to the slope as undefined, because division by 0 in mathematics is undefined. So when we calculate something like the slope between A and B, we will find that this is undefined because we'll have a 0 in the denominator. Okay, so let's go back and take a look at a line, and hopefully you see this is a line with a positive slope. And if I were to ask you what's the slope, well, many students say, well, I can't really tell if I don't have points. But actually you can if you notice there's several points, and I don't know what you'd call them when they're like right on this. We'll just call them an integer point because it's nice and easy to see that they hit right where the coordinate grid crosses. So it's kind of easy to identify those particular points. And if we can identify those points, and we can identify any two of those points, any two, I'll just pick two, how about those two? If we can, well, we can tell the slope, because as I go from left to right, all I have to look is what happens to my x or my y value as x increases. Well, my y value is going up until it reaches this level here. So how far does it go up, and how far does it rise as opposed to how far it runs? Well, it just depends. It depends on which points you pick. But if we look at this as it goes up 4, and then we notice it runs 6, our change of y up here, our change of y is 4, over the change of x, 6, which we would simplify to 2 over 3, so the slope of this line would be 2 over 3. Okay, another situation here. And again, looking at these two points, and now I don't have a grid. So right this second, it'd be impossible to find the slope. But I'm going to do a couple things. I'm going to go ahead and show a couple of lines that this line goes and crosses the y-axis at 9. This line crosses the y-axis at 5. So it gives me an idea of just how far it goes up or down. Now, it doesn't tell me where the y-axis is. It could be way over here, or it could be way over here. I don't know. But what I do know, that as I go left to right, as x increases, it doesn't matter, again, where the actual y-axis is, but as x increases, I see that the change in y is it goes from y equals 9 here to y equals 5 here. That change of y is a negative 4. Notice it goes down. Now, to figure out my negative x, I would need to know these lines, where they cross the x-axis. And if I said this one crossed at negative 2 and this one crossed at 6, I'm asking for how far does x change as we go from left to right. And as we go from a negative 2 to a positive 6, think of that on a number line, what would happen? We would be going up 8. So what we have here is a negative 4 over 8, of course, is a negative 1 over 2. Now, these two lines that cross the axes actually end up giving us the address of our points. This one being x is negative 2, y is 9, and our point over here, x is 6, and y is 5. And I show this as if I don't have a coordinate grid. Heck, if I didn't have the line at all, but I knew that two points, say point A and B, were on these two points, I could still find the slope. And I would use this simple formula here, just understanding that it's up to me to choose what I want to be as maybe point two and point one. It doesn't matter which one you choose. All I have to do is fill it in. So I will say that, I'm going to say that's point two, and this is point one. So all I have to do is plug it in. Remember that it's y over x, 9 over negative 2. And this one is y over x, 5 over 6. And notice what happens. 9 minus 5 is 4. Negative 2 minus 6 is negative 8. And when I simplify that, just like before, I get negative 1 over 2. Okay, so let's go ahead and work with just some pure points and the equation. So you go ahead and give this one a shot, calculating the slope of the line through the points using our equation. Okay, so we're going to use the equation here, and all we're doing is going to plug in. Now, notice what I did. I highlighted here, so I just have to pick a point one and a point two. And so what I'll do is I'll just go ahead and say this is my point two and this is my point one. Again, it doesn't matter which one you pick. All we have to do is make sure we fill it in correctly. Y over x. Y over x. Some simple calculations. I have a slope of negative 3 over 2. Okay, let's try another one. Go ahead and calculate that one. Okay. Again, simple as can be. We just have to select our points. Again, I'm just going to use this as 2 and 1 for no reason other than it's, you know, I just kind of line it up. But you could pick randomly either one. And again, just remembering y over x. Y over x. Some simple arithmetic here. Simplify this fraction, and we should get 3 over 4. Okay, if you want to practice, this is our homework, the answers are online, and we'll see you tomorrow.